Welcome to my second Sims speed build video. My name's Cookies, and I like to play video games. I also enjoy reading, and I even write a cheeky story now and then. Today we're going to see if I can build this farmhouse in The Sims. I really like the way it appears to have been built as additions rather than a whole. I'm pretty happy with the way the roof looks, and I think we can make this look pretty good. While we watch the footage, I have a new story to share with you. This is the story of how I bought my new car. I did a lot of research on vehicles, fuel mileage, and value retention. Then I researched which models had the features I really wanted. I was pretty easy. I wanted heated seats, air conditioning, and a manual transmission. I really wanted a 6-speed, but I told myself I could settle for a 5 if it was the right price. I started searching on AutoTrader and checking companies for lease returns. I found 3 6 hours away that were worth looking at. Where I live, it's pretty hard on vehicles, so it isn't unusual to travel to get a good quality used one. I decided a day trip was in order to test drive the vehicles. I emailed 3 different dealerships and made appointments. The first place that returned contact was happy to make an appointment. Yay! However, by the morning, the vehicle had sold to the manager there. A little sad, but it proved I had chosen well. Another company called me to make the appointment. He called himself Jeff in his quick introduction. He asked to speak to my husband. I replied that I was the one looking for the car, and he immediately took a tone of voice that was considerably degrading before asking me if I was aware it was a manual. The thing is, the 6-speed manual is a rare trade-in, meaning you have to really look to find one. They aren't something you stumble across and go, "Hey, that looks like a CVT." Now, I'm not saying don't mention it. I am saying, though, don't use the tone of voice and a choice of words which degrade or condescend to the buyer. Anywho, I digress. We ended up missing our first trip, and when we contacted Jeff again, it was his day off, and he referred us to a man named Max Steele. I wish I was kidding. The third company contacted me by phone, and Andy was very nice. We decided we'd test drive his vehicle first. The car drove like a dream, and I decided it was definitely the one for me. I made Andy a little unhappy when I asked for the bottom line, but sales is what it is. In the end, I agreed to the purchase, and I tried to use my debit to process the payment, but the card wouldn't work for the amount. I called the bank and they laughed. I would have to go to them and ask for the limit to be increased. I was a little leery, as I had just done so the last week, stating I was going to buy a car, and I was assured there would be no issue. I went to the closest location, and there I was told I would have to go to my specific branch as they had zero access to my money and my account. I put $3,000 down on the car before leaving. I came for my checking account, which I held at a different bank. I was horrified at how my savings bank had just made a fool of me. My anxiety was screaming that it was sure the dealership thought I was trying to put on some front. They kept assuring me that they could give me my down payment back. I was utterly mortified. However, I pulled myself together and I messaged Max to let him know I decided to purchase elsewhere. After all, it's impolite to leave someone hanging. I also let him know that I was inclined to purchase there after Jeff's first point of contact. As a woman, his question really made me leery of dealing at that dealership. Side note, I make stupid mistakes sometimes. Turns out, I had texted Jeff instead of Max. He attempted to apologize in his reply, but he made a typo, and in that apology, it actually said that he meant to harm me with his words. It was one of the few things I found pretty funny that day. I drove the 6 hours home and had to wait to see my bank in the morning. I wasted no time heading down. After a lot of consideration, instead of asking to have my daily limit increased, I asked for the balance in full and to close the account. The teller looked at my account, and then she got really snooty with me, demanding to know why I would want to close it. I explained I'd been in, I'd asked for access, I was assured it would be fine, but it didn't work out that way. I was left in a very uncomfortable position, and I didn't want to repeat it. I kid you not. This woman had the gall to say she needed to ask her manager if she was allowed to close my account. This is my money, and there's nothing like this in your terms of service. Stating your manager had any say in it, put off she went. the manager arrived, she had tried to assure me that it would never happen again. I smiled and said I knew it wouldn't, and to please close my account. A bank draft or check would be for the full balance would be fine in my eyes. She stammered a bit, and then she tried to tell me that she couldn't release my funds for 24 hours. Not gonna lie. I did smell that baloney. I smiled, and I thanked her for the offer. I told her I needed the funds that day, and as she's in management, she would have no trouble getting it all in order. I reminded her that it was her staff's error that caused me this concern, and, you know, they would still have my account if they had just done what they were asked. I wasn't asking for cash. I was asking for a check, and honestly, it was starting to feel like I was going to have to call the authorities, or maybe the ombudsman. I kind of mentioned so under my breath. It was then she stepped in front of the computer and in a few minutes produced the check I was looking for. Though she refused me a printout showing my zero balance, and she didn't give me a copy of my request to close the account. Those will come in the mail, I guess? I ended up driving to my other bank. I cashed the check and transferred the remaining funds plus the delivery charge I was now faced with to the dealership. Since the vehicle was still located 6 hours away, and rides are hard to come by in this crazy, crazy time, it felt like the best option. The dealership called the next day, and we did all the paperwork by phone and email. Even the insurance. Seems legit, right? After all was said and done, they told me it would be several days before it could be delivered. So now I just had to play the waiting game. I got a call on Thursday evening, around 5 o'clock, saying the vehicle was loaded, ready to go, and should arrive by 11 p.m. Not bad. I made arrangements with the dispatcher to meet at the Husky. They have a huge, well-lit parking lot, and there's hardly anyone there after dark. Well, 9 p.m. rolled around, and I got a call from the driver, telling me he was going to be through at 2:30 a.m. It was what it was. He said he would call me 15 minutes out of town so we could meet up. That seemed reasonable. I knew I could walk to the Husky in 15 minutes. When the driver called me, he asked if I could meet him across town instead of the location we had originally arranged. It was late, and I kind of huffed that it would be at least 45 minutes and would take me through seedy parts of town. He backpedaled and said he would text me after he was done. It wasn't long before he texted me again and wanted to meet at McDonald's, which was also well-lit, and it made it so I didn't have to cross the highway, so I agreed and left my house within minutes. I'm not gonna lie, I didn't leave my house empty-handed, and while I walked, I chatted on the phone with a friend working nights. I didn't hang up when I greeted the man who had taken my car off the rig. He was about 6'6", but he had a kind-looking baby face. He was very apologetic for the time and me having to walk down. He mentioned the man who was dropping off my car was about 4 hours late. I smiled and said it was funny because they told me my car was loaded at about 5 p.m. He just shook his head, and all I could do was laugh. None of it really mattered. After all, the car was here now, and I'm a night owl anyway. Even though he seemed nice, I didn't hang up the phone until it was safe in my new car. I was ready to drive home, though the experience may have been a bit harrowing. I'm sure happy with the new set of wheels. This is my car. Check it out. It's awesome. Pretty good for a girl, right? Now that my story's out of the way, what do you guys think of my build? Do you think I nailed it, or did I fail it? If you like what you see, please comment, like, and subscribe. Maybe even ring the bell for notifications. I'll put this up on the gallery under Kiara_Brynn. And remember, all my content is base game, which means it's console compatible. I want to say thanks so much for watching. See y'all next time. Bye, guys!